Hi, I'm Andy Webb from BeCleverWithYourCash.com. Now, whether you're a TSB customer or not, you can't escape that there's been an absolute meltdown with their online banking and app banking. Lots of issues, including lots of people not being able to get into their account. And that means they've not been able to withdraw money when they've needed it, not transfer it to people where payments have been really, really essential, paying bills, all this kind of stuff. It's been an absolute nightmare for those customers. So whether you're a TSB customer or not, I've got three tips that I think are worth following, worth having kind of a bit of a backup to protect yourself if this was to ever happen again, whatever bank you're with. You know, the more we rely on this technology, the more the branches shut down. Any IT failure could be a big, big problem. So three things I think you should do. First of all, automate as many payments as you can. So if you've got a credit card that you're paying off every month, whether that's the whole balance, which is obviously the best thing to do so you avoid any interest payments, or whether you're just making a chunk payment every month, set it up as a direct debit. Same for all your bills. These direct debits or standing orders will go out on the same day every month. So if you can't access your account for whatever reason, that payment should hopefully still be made. So that's the first thing to do. Obviously, make sure that you're going to have money in the account when those payments are due to go. So ideally, try and time those payments for bills and whatever they might be for just after payday, so you know you've got a decent chunk of cash in your account. Second one, well, you might want to think about moving your bank to one where there's a local branch. As I said, lots of these are shutting down. These are announced all the time that branches are getting shut all across the country. But if worse comes to worse and you can't get on your app, if there's one that's within walking or driving distance, at least you might be able to get some kind of support. There's obviously phone banking, which is a good backup, but you've got to make sure you keep those security details somewhere. More things to remember, but if you've got them somewhere safe, then that's another option. Yet when you have big crashes like this one with TSB just now, it's been a nightmare apparently getting through on the phones. And then my last tip is to open up a second bank account with a different bank and put some cash in there. Now, you're allowed to have as many as you want. I've got about 12 for all sorts of different reasons, whether that's getting interest or fee-free spending overseas and all sorts of things in between. But if you can, just have a second bank account with a chunk of cash in there. It's unlikely that if one goes down, so will another. So at least you're going to be able to access a bit of cash if you need it. There you go. Good luck with that. Hope if you are a TSB customer that you're not too badly affected. Got more information on the blog actually, that how to complain, how to hopefully get some compensation if you are out of pocket as a result. So do check that out. I'm Andy Webb. It's BeCleverWithYourCash.com, and thanks for watching. Cheers.